We leave behind our everyday concerns, the world of Kronos. We set aside our watches and turn off our phones. We don't count this time as ordinary, measured by the ticking of the clock.
Ecola Jinga, man, is that a joint, man? No, man, it's time for the Vinyl Crusade! With your host, Mike Puskas, the man.
The man.
With a man.
Thank you very much.
Joyful possibility becomes reality.
And welcome everybody to another episode of the Vinyl Crusade with your host Mike Puskas from the Seven Sense. And I want to begin from the get-go to apologize for not being available last week. I don't want to get into too much of the details. Suffice to say that there was a lot that was bombarding my singularity as a human on the planet Earth, dealing with all this new integration energy in an effort to get back to a zero point, a neutral balance, to be dealing with all of the heavy duty fallout taking place across the world. Music, in my opinion, has never become more important right now because it is an absolute go-to destination as far as an escape, as far as seeking sanctuary. And to a greater degree, it's also the catalyst for inspiring the powerful, harder, more angsty kind of style and sound and vibration and frequency that I've chosen in the last 7 to 8 days to immerse myself in. Now, sometimes, let's face it, things just don't go to plan. We'd like it to be. We look at the world, we see it in a certain way, and we start scratching our head and saying, what's gone wrong here? Why doesn't the world look the way I want it to look? And ultimately, is there a reason why I feel really detached and very much affected by my given environment? What can I do to placate the situation? Because I certainly can't turn it around at this point while everything is topsy-turvy, upside down, and, you know, as I said, bombarding my singularity at a million miles an hour. But what I can do is I can kind of placate it, create a moment of pause, if you like, where I can focus on settling back into a balanced, liberated outlook of my plane of reality. Angsty music, the punk scene, classic, Never Mind the Bollocks, the Sex Pistols, Sham 69, Generation X, Susie and the Banshees, Early Cure, The Buzzcocks, The Damned. Most of those are predominantly English groups, but there was also a great deal of American angst being released. And this is really what I would call pre-pop punk, which came in with the CBGBs and the Bowery Place, Arlene's Grocery, New York City, early 70s, Television, Patti Smith, Blondie, and so on, Iggy Pop and the Stooges, and of course the Ramones. But what about today? What about the post-punk pop crossover albums of today, the ones that ultimately set the scene for what is known as the millennials? Well, I thought, while I've been waiting for some more inspiration to kind of get me going, motivate me to action, I'd do a Vinyl Crusade on the 20 best post-punk albums of 2020 so far. And that is January through June, coming to the end of June in four short days, when July comes along and we pretty much kickstart the second half of this rather madcap year. I'm not going to dwell greatly, and I'm certainly not going to be playing a lot of the musical tracks from these particular records, because it is, after all, 20 selections and or choices from probably what is pool of at least 1,000. So it's 20% of a larger 1,000 pool selection base. So in a year full of album release delays, and it feels a bit weird to share a best of list at a halfway point of a year like 2020. But it seems like most punk LPs, as opposed to the big pop rock or hip hop releases of the day, were largely unaffected. Whether it's the danceable rhythms, the razor sharp social commentary, or mind bending guitars, post-punk helped us process today's extremely tumultuous circumstances, and boy, are things way, way out of balance. You're either super hard left, almost hardcore intense, or you're super hard right, almost hardcore intense. There really is no neutral position. That zero point of energy that we all desperately lack right now is what's creating the delusion and really muddying up the lens through which we're presenting ourselves, expressing ourselves in our plane of reality. So whether we're talking about the new wave side of things, Nation of Language, Choir Boy, punk and jangle pop fusion, and Attendant and Primo, or even gothic gloom, Bambara, MRM, these records helped us all escape and return to our lives with a renewed vigor. Post-punk has been kind to us in 2020, so we'd like to tip our hat to the highlights. And in here we go, what I consider to be the 20 favorite post-punk albums from this year so far, listed in alphabetical order. Now, there is in fact a link to a Spotify playlist which you can check out on our Twitter page at magazine.today, twitter.com, magazine.today, or go to magazine.today, go to the TV hub, and there we will post the entire list of the albums, and we've also underlined what we consider to be worthy tracks that ultimately you should perhaps consider listening to, checking out. Number one, Back Eye, Pleasure Vision. Let me spell that for everybody. Back Eye, B-A-C-C-H-A-E. The new LP from DC Punk's Back Eye is an exhilarating listen with sharp riffs and a vast arsenal of sounds. One minute there's smoke coming out of their noses on the spring-loaded goth ripper Leave Town, then the next they're embracing cheerful twee pop in Hammer, or bringing out fried synths from Left Field Turns Me. From the biting vocals of Older I Get to the jaunty, bewitching organs on Life Online, Back Eye out themselves as compelling punk shapeshifters. Check out Turns Me, Pleasure Vision. Number two, Bambara, Stray. Athens, Garvia, Brooklyn band Bambara employ fictional